Hello students, today we are going to discuss chirality, symmetry planes and enantiomers, optical activity. As you know that we are discussing stereochemistry and it is my second lecture on stereochemistry. A few of topics we have discussed on in our previous class, that is about the introduction of stereoisomers, isomers, what are constitutional isomers, what are stereoisomers, type of stereoisomers, configurational and conformational. And in configurational, there are two type of geometric or optical isomer, geometrical isomer or optical isomers. Optical isomers are again of two categories, that is enantiomers and diastereomers. So this is a basic chart through which we can understand the basic terminology of stereochemistry and there the types of stereoisomers at different level. So first of all, we will discuss the plane of symmetry. A plane of symmetry is which divides the object into equal halves. It means it divides the entire molecule into two pieces that are exact mirror image of each other. So we can observe the same thing in this example of this car, that the car have plane of symmetry, that this is the imaginary plane that divides the car into two equal parts. Yes, so let us discuss the example of plane of symmetry in case of molecules. One molecule is there in the example and this molecule has a plane of symmetry. In this figure we can clearly see that this is the plane of symmetry which divides the molecule into two equal parts. Here we can draw the symmetry plane like this, that divides the molecule into two equal parts. So we can say this is the plane of symmetry. This is also an example of a compound which has plane of symmetry. You can observe the imaginary plane. Yes, so plane of symmetry. After plane of symmetry, the next term is chirality. It is basically the object which have plane of symmetry. It will be identical with its mirror image and it will superimpose on its mirror image. Such objects are known as a chiral object. Very simple definition of a chiral object is a molecule with a plane of symmetry is the same as its mirror image and it's said to be a chiral. On the other hand, some molecules are there, they do not have plane of symmetry, that's why their mirror images are not superimposable on their mirror on them, and such molecules are known as chiral. Chiral molecules basically have the property of handness. It means we can identify in such object which is the left part and which is the right part. So such objects showing the property of handness or are non-superimposable on its mirror image, these are known as chiral object, and chiral object are of prime interest in stereochemistry. Basically, we discussed the chiral object. So we can conclude that absence of plane of symmetry is essential condition for a molecule to be chiral. Let us discuss the example of chiral. So very simple example of chiral is our hand. Our hand have handness. It means both the sides are not equal. Not equal, it means it doesn't have any plane of symmetry. And also it do not superimpose on its mirror image. Hence we can say that our hand is a chiral object. This is example of a chiral object. This is a car. We have discussed that a car has a plane of symmetry, that's why its mirror image will superimpose on its mirror image. Hence it will be a chiral object. So in terms of chemical compounds, to be a molecule chiral, the essential condition, one of the condition is chiral carbon, presence of chiral carbon. So what is chiral carbon? Chiral carbon is basically a carbon present in the molecule which have four different groups attached with it. Here this is the carbon which is asterisk mark, which that carbon is chiral carbon. These are the four different groups that attached here with, that attached with this carbon. So such carbon are known as chiral carbon, and in most of the cases the compound have chiral carbon are chiral, but it is not the essential condition of chirality. So what is the essential one? Another term of related to chirality, that is stereocenter. What is stereocenter? It is similar with the chiral carbon. A stereocenter is an atom or a group of atom that can potentially causes a molecule to be a chiral. So stereocenter can give rise to chirality. Stereocenter doesn't indicate the central carbon atom which have four different groups. Stereocenters may be an imaginary center in the molecule that defines the chirality. Stereogenic carbon, it is another terms. It is also similar like chiral carbon. So this is the carbon. This carbon atom has all the four groups, different four groups. So that's why this carbon atom, four group, this is known as stereogenic center. Now a chiral compounds have plane of symmetry. Such molecules are known as a chiral compounds because they superimpose on their mirror image as per the definition. This is also example of a compound which has this plane as plane of symmetry. Now the next term is enantiomer. What are these? Enantiomers are stereoisomers which are mirror images of each other. Look at these. This example, there are two compounds. What is the relation between these two? These two may have different physical property. These two may have different physical or chemical property, but they have same molecular formula. So definitely they are stereoisomer of each other. On the other hand, what is the relationship between them? They are mirror image of each other. So such stereoisomer which are mirror images of each other are known as enantiomers. So this is a pair of enantiomers. And what is the essential condition to be a for enantiomerism? The compound should be chiral. It means if the compound is chiral, it will not be superimposed on its mirror image and it will show enantiomerism. This is the important property of enantiomers. They have equal and opposite optical rotations. Equal and opposite optical rotations. Here we can see that NN degree in plus and here NN degree with the minus signs. It means the amount of optical rotation is the same, but it is with the different sign. If it is plus, then we call it dextrorotatory, and if it is minus, then we call it levorotatory. All other physical properties of the enantiomers are same. It is very important to note. Here we have discussed some terms related to optical activity, which we will discuss in the next part. Another example of enantiomers. Enantiomers have different optical properties but have same, or the rest of physical properties are same. The next one is optical activity. Optical, a few terms are there related to optical activity. Let us discuss these terms. Number one is plane polarized light. The light that is restricted to pass through a plane. Another, the plane polarized light that passes through a solution of chiral compound remains in the plane. This is also plane polarized light. If the solution of a chiral compound rotate plane polarized light and the molecules are said to be optically active. So what is the meaning of optically active? If the compound rotates the plane of plane polarized light, it interacts with the plane polarized light, it is known as optical activity. The phenomena of optical activity was discovered by Biot in early 19th century. What is PPL? Plane polarized light. Plane polarized light is the light where the sine waves are not aligned. It is the non-unpolarized beam where the sine waves are not aligned in the same plane. And if we pass through a Nicole prism, that light, then the light become plane polarized light where the sine wave are aligned in the single plane. This is the experimental setup to check the optical activity. Optical activity, again, I repeating the definition, the molecule is said to be optical active if it rotates the plane of PPL. Here, this is the sample cell. We place the solution of the sample. This side, we can see that the plane of PPL is rotated by the angle alpha. So it means we can conclude that the compound which solution is filled here, that is optically active. This thing we have already discussed. Yes, what happened here? Light passes through a plane polarizer. Plane polarized light is rotated in solution of optically active compound. This whole instrumental setup is known as polarimeter, and the optical rotation is measured in degrees. Clockwise rotation is known as dextrorotatory, and anticlockwise rotation is known as levorotatory. A few details of one important topic is specific rotation. What is specific rotation? The number of degrees that the plane of polarized light is rotated as the light passes through a solution of enantiomer depends on the number of chiral molecule in the sample. This course depends on the length of the tube and concentration of the enantiomer. Enantiomers are stereoisomer, which have discussed the definition. Enantiomers rotate the plane of PPL by exactly the same number of degrees but in opposite direction. What is specific rotation? Specific rotation can be calculated by this formula where alpha is observed rotation, C is concentration in gram per ml, and L is length of sample tube in decimeter. So the definition of specific rotation is the rotation produced by a solution of unit concentration and unit length is known as specific rotation. So this is all for today's portion of stereochemistry. Thank you and best of luck. Keep learning stereochemistry.